Governor John Vic, there are reports of two barangay officials in Cavite that they were caught having sex during a Zoom meeting, and the DILG said they will be investigating this matter. What exactly happened?
Well, it was a Zoom meeting among all barangay officials in Las Marinas City. There were 500 participants in it, and they were all giving updates about the COVID situation. Apparently, the barangay captain is not very familiar with technology or how to use Zoom, and he chose to engage in a dalliance with his barangay secretary, thinking that when you mute it, that the video would be off also. He didn't know any better. Well, what they did was inexcusable, but it is largely an ignorance of the use of technology which led to all of this.
All right. I'm curious, are you able to take action against him, or this is completely under the DILG's jurisdiction at this point?
Well, he resigned. Okay. That's number one. Is the barangay secretary resigned? What is there to investigate? What is there to prosecute? It was an act of two consenting adults, although it was they were both married, and it was not a proper relationship. There's nothing more to investigate. They resigned. There is no punitive clause that of what they did should be fined. Whoever spread it, it's impossible to trace who did it. It's gone viral. So I think my bigger concern is the mental health well-being of the barangay captain.
Yeah.
He was suicidal last week, and it's a good thing that the other barangay captains were very encouraging of him. So I hope that his he is better. I hope that his family is better, because it was kind of tenuous for a while.
Yeah, that's quite interesting, Governor John Vic, because you said he already resigned. So technically, there is nothing to investigate anymore. And how does that work? Who takes over his post?
Number one barangay councilor will take over his post.
And that's happened already?
It's happened. It happens often. Not because of a scandal, but largely because some of them have passed away. If someone passes away, there is a succession system inside it.
Even with the DILG, there's no punitive clause, because Undersecretary Malaya said that it could violate what he calls a good conduct clause for public officials.
I think it's almost useless to put a punitive clause on this person. There's nothing to solve. It's been solved. I think the burden of humiliation is larger than any punitive clause that you could give him. I feel very sorry for the family. I've met the families of both officials. I feel very sorry for them, because they have to bear this burden for the rest of their lives. The Spariñas is a very close community. The houses are packed. Santa Fe is a very dense community. And if someone cooks adobo, you can smell what your neighbors are cooking. It's that dense. So they have to bear with this, and the burden is very, very great, and I feel very sorry for them.
Yeah, the sex scandal is bad enough, but the fact that they're both married and possibly have children.
Yes, they both, and I have learned that the couples have processed it, and they have. I think forgiveness has been given. I think they've chosen to move on. But that healing is only 1/10 of the entire damage that has been done. The reputational damage is so much greater, not only for the barangay officials. They should bear it. They deserve to bear it. But their children and their relatives and the people in their barangay, there's a great deal of shame that comes with it, and I feel very sorry for them.
Okay. You said something interesting before we move on to another topic. There's no way of actually finding out who spread it, as there were 500. I didn't even know, Governor.
Well, I didn't want to see the video. Because once you see it, you can't unsee it.
Yeah.
But for the little that I saw, you could see screenshots going left and right. You see a screenshot in Zoom, you could tell there's a image which appears. And it's recorded. And how could you trace 500 people, and who spread it, and who recorded it, and who shared it with whom? It's almost impossible.
Yeah. No, my next question is, would there be some kind of effort, even as a form of protection for the two and their families to ask, I don't know where it spread, if it's Facebook or YouTube, to take down these videos. Because I do know that Facebook and YouTube have taken down, I mean, pornographic material.
Yeah, I don't think that's the bigger problem is in Viber and WhatsApp. That's where it's spreading and that's where it's uncontrollable. Mm-mm. And that's how it spread mainly, not through Facebook.
Is there any message you'd like to, give out right now to all your barangay chairman in the province before we leave this subject?
Well, number one, yung mga pinagagawa nyo ay hindi ko naman pwede kayo lecturean tungkol sa moralidad. Pero para kaawa nyo na, pag-aralan nyo muna paano gumamit ng Zoom, paano gumamit ng WebEx, lahat yan pag-aralan muna. I think the bigger thing is that I do not condone their behavior, mm-hmm. but I do ask for compassion for their families. Mm-hmm. They're going through a great deal, and I think we owe them that.
All right. Now, before we end news this week on a national scale, the United States just this week blacklisted 24 Chinese corporations involved in the reclamation of the West Philippine Sea. And it turns out one of those corporations, the China Construction and Communications Company, or CCCC, is actually involved in the building of Sangli Airport. So my first question is, will this have an impact on the project? And what phase are you in when it comes now to building Sangli with Macro Asia?
Well, number one, the joint venture between CCC and Macro Asia is about to be completed. It's not perfected yet. Mm-mm. Their boards have to approve it. And it should be done in the next few, maybe in a month, it should be perfected. But it's a national security issue. If the president says, if the Department of National Defense says that it's a security risk to enter into an agreement with them, then we will cease all, we will terminate the agreements immediately. Mm-mm. But these things we have to have the national government chime in on it and have their own risk assessment of mm-hmm. what's going on. But I want to build an airport. We found a partner. It seems that they're involved in the South China Sea issue. But I will leave it up to the Department of National Defense. I will leave it up to the Office of the President to guide us in how we should pursue this.
Mm-mm. All right. Because what's interesting is China actually reacted to the U.S. move and said that sanctions against these companies is unfair. So you are leaving it to the national government to make a decision when it comes to retaining CCCC yes. in terms of their involvement with Sangli. Okay, that's one thing clear. And the other thing I'm curious is the House granted tax incentives to San Miguel's Bulacan Airport project. Do you believe that a similar consideration should be given to Sangli? Because the Sangli project in the end is a PPP with Macro Asia, between Macro Asia and the Cavite provincial government. So would you want the same tax considerations?
Well, as long as it's, let me make it clear, I want a level playing field and I want a fair playing field. As long as it's not tax avoidance, then I'd want to have the same thing. I think Bulacan deserves it. I think we deserve it. We will apply for it, and I hope they grant it to us.
Mm-mm. All right. Perhaps after COVID, you may have to face, well, I don't know if this will actually happen, but InfraWatch PH has actually been calling on Congress to investigate how the province has closed this contract. They question issues like the bidding. Why did Cavite actually just close or pick one company? You did answer this in several other interviews. But just to close this part of the Sangli interview, given the update on the U.S. blacklist, why did you end up with Macro Asia? It's a $10 billion project. Shouldn't you have opened yourself to more choices?
Karen, we followed all procedures of the PPP code of the Cavite, which is based on the PPP code of the country. We opened up, our books are open. We are more than willing to let it go under public scrutiny. we will turn all over all emails, all communications on how we arrived at the decision. And I think in the end, we'll bear fruit that we did everything correctly and above board. Mm-hmm. Now, I welcome them if they want to question us. We're more than open to the Congress, we're more than open to FRPH. I invite them to go to the Capitol to look at our papers. I invite them to look at all our communications. And then only the truth will set us free. And I think we were above board.
Okay. Now, Governor John Vic, I know that Macro Asia is still submitting. You gave them another 90-day extension, yes. Am I correct, no? For yes. some documents that they need to submit. If after the 90 days and then all goes well with construction, when are you seeing the airport come into fruition?
If everything goes according to the adjusted plan, the first two runways, the first war runway should be built by 2023. Mm. I think that's the earliest, because way after the claim, you have to let it settle, then you have to build the temporary terminal. But all in all, I think it'll take around 6 years for the entire project to come into fruition.
All right. On that note, Governor John Vic Remulla, I want to thank you so much for giving us your time this morning. I appreciate it, and stay safe.
Thank you, Karen. Thank you. Thank you very much to everyone.